Welcome to Aberdeen Drilling Consultants Virtual Academy. The Virtual Academy is an online training environment for the oil and gas industry, which covers rig inspection, drilling equipment, dropped objects, and level 2 well control training. This video will demonstrate the process of drilling a subsea well. When the rig is moved onto location and anchored in position, the rig management is then handed over from the marine department to the drilling department. This diagram demonstrates the planned depth and size of each casing shoe. The first operation is to spud the well. Spudding the well means to start drilling. In this example, this is done by drilling a 36-inch hole. The drill string components comprise of a 26-inch bit and 36-inch hole opener, followed by drill collars, heavyweight drill pipe, and drill pipe. The drilling assembly is then run in the sea to tag the seabed. As the drill string is rotated, sea water is pumped through the drill string and out through the bit and hole opener jets. The drill string is then lowered and the drilling of the well begins. The 36-inch hole section is drilled to approximately 400 feet below the seabed. When the required hole depth has been achieved, the hole section is circulated clean and the drill string pulled out of the hole. The next operation is to run 30-inch casing with a guide base and well head attached at the top of the casing. Once the casing has been landed and circulated, a cement job is carried out. The cement is pumped down through the running string and out through the shoe of the casing. The cement is pumped up between the casing and the formation until returns are seen at the seabed. Once the cement has been pumped and solidified in place, the casing running string is pulled out of the hole. The next operation is to drill a 26-inch hole. The following bottom hole assembly components make up the bottom of the drill string. That is, a 26-inch bit, a near bit stabilizer, one drill collar, a string stabilizer, several drill collars, heavyweight drill pipe, and drill pipe. We are currently at the first casing shoe. The 26-inch bit and drill string is run in the water and stabbed into the 30-inch casing wellhead. The string is then lowered until the drill bit tags the cement inside the 30-inch casing. The cement and the 30-inch casing shoe is drilled out, and the next section of the hole is drilled to approximately 2,500 feet. Once the depth is reached and the geologists have agreed that this is the best point for the next casing shoe, the hole is circulated clean. The drill string is then pulled out of the hole. The next operation is to run the 20-inch casing. This casing will have an 18¾-inch well head attached at the top of the casing. The 20-inch casing is run in the sea and stabbed into the 30-inch well head. The 20-inch casing is run in the hole until the 18¾-inch well head hanger is landed in the 30-inch well head housing. The next operation is to cement the casing in place by pumping a calculated amount of cement. The cement is pumped down through the running string and down through the 20-inch casing. Once the cement has been pumped, a calculated amount of fluid is also pumped down the same path. This is to aid in correctly positioning the cement slurry as it travels through the shoe and up between the formation and the outer casing and up between the 20-inch and 30-inch casing. We are currently at the second casing shoe. Once the cement job is complete, the casing running string is pulled out of the hole. The next operation is to run, land, and latch the blowout preventer on the 18¾-inch wellhead. The blowout preventer is a large, specialized sealing device used to seal, control, and monitor oil and gas wells to prevent and control the release of oil, water, or gas from a well. The next operation is to run the 17½-inch bit and bottom hole assembly. The drill string is run in the hole until the bit tags the hardened cement. The cement and casing shoe is drilled out, and the drilling of the next section of hole continues to approximately 7,000 feet. The fluid used for drilling the well when the BOP is installed is called mud. There are different types of drilling mud. The main reason for using drilling mud include providing hydrostatic pressure to prevent the formation fluids from entering into the wellbore, keeps the drill bit cool, clean, and lubricated during drilling, carries the drilling cuttings out of the well, and also suspends the drill cuttings while drilling is paused and when the drilling assembly is pulled in and out of the hole. When this section of hole is drilled to the proposed depth, the hole is circulated clean and the drill string pulled out of the hole. The next string of casing to be run is a 13¾-inch. This casing has a shoe joint at the bottom and a float approximately 80 feet up from the shoe. The casing string is run and the casing hanger landed in the wellhead. The depth of the casing shoe is calculated so that when the casing hanger is landed in the wellhead, the casing shoe will be approximately 15 feet from the current drill depth. This area between the casing and the well bottom is called the sump, and its purpose is to collect any debris that may be knocked from the formation as the casing is run. Another important reason is to keep the casing in tension and not in compression when being landed. The 13¾-inch casing cement job is then carried out. The right amount of cement is then calculated for the job. Wiper plugs are required for this cementing operation. These plugs will be used one in front of the cement and one after the cement. Their purpose is to keep the cement slurry separate from other fluids. The first wiper plug is released and the calculated amount of cement is pumped down through the casing. Once the cement is pumped, the second wiper plug is released and drilling mud then used to chase the cement down the casing. When the first wiper plug lands on the float, a ruptured disc ruptures which allows the cement to pass through. The chaser mud is constantly pumped until the second wiper plug lands on the first wiper plug on top of the float. The second wiper plug forms a seal so no further fluid can be circulated through. Note here that the top of the cement is only a few hundred feet inside the last casing shoe and does not rise all the way to the wellhead. The positioning of the cement is to prevent the formation being fractured with the weight of a full column of cement back to surface. Once the casing has been cemented, the casing landing string is pulled out of the hole. We are currently at the third casing shoe. The next operation is to make up and run in the hole the 12¼-inch drilling assembly until the drill bit tags the top of the upper plug on top of the float. The wiper plugs, float, cement and shoe are drilled out. The drilling of the 12¼-inch hole continues to a depth of approximately 9,500 feet. The hole is circulated clean and the drilling assembly pulled out of the hole. calculated amount of 9 5/8 casing with a casing hanger at the top is run in the hole. Once the casing hanger has landed in the wellhead, the 9 5/8 casing shoe will be approximately 15 feet off the last drill depth. The casing cement job is then carried out with a calculated amount of cement. Wiper plugs are required for the cementing operation. The cement is pumped and positioned in place using mud to chase the cement down the casing. We are currently at the fourth casing shoe. The casing running string is pulled out of the hole to make way for the 8.5-inch drilling assembly. The 8.5-inch drilling assembly is run in the hole until the bit tags the top of the upper plug on top of the float. The wiper plugs, float, cement and shoe are drilled out. The drilling of the 8.5-inch hole continues to a depth of approximately 10,000 feet. Once the hole has been circulated clean, the drilling assembly is pulled out of the hole. The next operation is to run 7-inch liner. This liner casing string does not extend to the top of the wellbore, but instead is anchored, suspended, from inside the bottom of the previous casing string. A quantity of 7-inch liner with a liner hanger at the top is calculated and run in the hole so that the liner hanger does not sit at the same depth as any of the threaded connections of the 9 5/8 casing and will leave the 7-inch liner shoe 15 feet off bottom. The liner hanger is hung in place inside the last 9 5/8 casing string. Cementing operations are carried out to cement the liner in place. Once the liner is cemented in place, the liner packers are expanded to seal and the running tool and string are pulled out of the hole. Now that the well is at the total drilling depth and the casings are cemented in place, the preparation of the well is complete and the oil company can now decide on how they are going to use this well. If you would like to find out more about the content covered within these webisodes or about the Virtual Academy, then please contact Aberdeen Drilling Consultants.